Hello everyone, you're welcome back to my channel. Today we'll be discussing superior vena cava syndrome. So let's get started. Superior vena cava syndrome occurs when the superior vena cava is compressed or obstructed by a growth or tumor in the mediastinum. It is usually associated with lung cancer or lymphoma. The signs and symptoms occur because there is blockage of the blood flow of the venous system of the head, the neck, and the upper trunk. The signs and symptoms are divided into three: the early signs, the late signs, and the life-threatening signs. The early signs occurs in the morning when there's edema of the face, especially around the eyes, and there is tightness of shirt or blouse collar. This is called the Stokes sign. Late signs of superior vena cava syndrome includes edema in the arms and hands, dyspnea, erythema or skin redness of the upper body, swelling of the veins in the chest and neck, and epistaxis, nosebleeds. The life-threatening signs and symptoms are airway obstruction, hemorrhage, cyanosis, mental disturbances, mental status changes, decreased cardiac output, and hypotension. These are life-threatening signs and symptoms. The intervention: assess for early signs and symptoms of superior vena cava syndrome. Place the patient in a semi-fowler's position and give prescribed diuretics and corticosteroids. Prepare the client for high-dose radiation therapy to the mediastinal area and for possible surgery to insert a metal stent into the vena cava. Thanks for watching. See you in my next video.